We begin with breaking news, and the truck driver who killed four police officers in Melbourne's Eastern Freeway tragedy has just been sentenced. Reporter Eliza Rugg was in court and joins us now. Eliza, how long will Mahinda Singh spend behind bars?
Brett, Mahinda Singh has been sentenced to 22 years jail for causing the deadliest day in the history of Victoria Police. He must serve 18 years and 6 months before he is eligible for parole. Singh remained silent throughout the hearing. He was actually led out of the courtroom directly in front of the victims' families. They all stared at him as he was led out. We're outside the Supreme Court at the moment, just waiting for them to come out and make a statement. The judge described this crime as one that shocked the public consciousness here in Victoria. He noted the events of what happened to Mahinda Singh in the lead up, his drug dealing, drug using, and the fact that it was chilling. The vision of the crash was so chilling to watch, and it was clear that the police officers never stood a chance. We know that on April 22 last year, Mahinda Singh was so fatigued, he barely slept in 3 days when he got behind the wheel and he made the decision to drive. The judge slammed him as selfish, but the judge also noted that Mahinda Singh, since then, he's shown remorse and he put in an early guilty plea. That's what's led the judge to this sentence of 22 years, which is a high sentence for culpable driving causing death here in Victoria. Unfortunately, this is not the end of the legal process for the victims' families. In a couple of weeks, they have to come back to court. That's for the sentence of Richard Pusey, the Porsche driver who filmed the dying police officers on the Eastern Freeway. And Brett, next week marks 1 year since this tragedy. Victoria Police is planning a private memorial service for those families.
What a time for the families. All right, Eliza Rugg, thank you. To breaking news out of Adelaide now, and a former Labor MP has been charged with blackmailing the state party leader. Let's go live to Oliver Haig. Oliver, what can you tell us?
Well, Brett, former Labor MP and federal candidate Annabelle Digance and her husband Greg have been arrested at their Adelaide Hills home this morning. Our cameras capturing the moments the couple were driven separately into the police watch house. The pair arrested by major crime detectives this morning. In a bombshell development that will rock SA politics, they've been charged with blackmailing the state political opposition leader Peter Malinauskas. It's reported the threats include making false accusations about Mr. Malinauskas' conduct in order to politically wound him. If proven, blackmail can carry a prison term of 20 years for an aggravated offence. The pair are expected to appear at the Adelaide Magistrates Court today, but certainly very big developing news coming out of Adelaide this morning, Brett.
Indeed. Oliver Haig, thank you. Former Australia Post CEO Christine Holgate says all she wants from the Prime Minister is an apology for being hung in Parliament over the Cartier Watches scandal. Let's go to federal politics reporter Jonathan Kersley with the latest. Jono, Scott Morrison has just responded. What did he have to say?
Well, no apology from the Prime Minister at this stage, Brett. Scott Morrison stopping well short of that, but he did say that his comments in Parliament, where he said that Christine Holgate could go as Australia Post CEO, had hurt her deeply, but Scott Morrison said that that was not his intention. Miss Holgate said that she had been humiliated by the Prime Minister on that day last year, but speaking on a podcast just a short time ago, Scott Morrison said he appreciated Miss Holgate has gone through a difficult time, but that he does not think this is a gender issue. He says it was all about the misuse of taxpayer funds. This is all from the fallout of Christine Holgate's decision to spend $20,000 on Cartier watches as rewards for four staff members. Miss Holgate was asked to stand aside at the time after these revelations were made, and eventually she left the company, but now claims she was bullied by the Australia Post chair, a claim Lucio Di Bartolomeo denies. But again this morning on Today on Nine, Miss Holgate repeated her claim she was bullied. As she said, at times she felt suicidal and described it as being like Davina fighting Goliath.
You know, everybody makes mistakes sometimes. And if he was to call me and apologise, I would welcome that apology. I that's all I want. It's all the people have wanted. We just want respect. We just want to stop to bullying and humiliation.
Scott Morrison once again attempting to blame someone else for actions for which he himself is solely responsible. No one wrote Scott Morrison's script for him in Question Time.
Brett, at the time of all of this, it was Labor driving the watches issue as well, and at the time they also said that Christine Holgate's position was untenable. But Scott Morrison is now facing a very familiar problem. It's a problem he's faced for months and for most of this year, and that is the issue of how women are treated in the workplace. Brett.
Jonathan Kersley, thank you. And it's not the only headache Scott Morrison is facing as he tries to fix problems surrounding the vaccine rollout. The PM has asked National Cabinet to meet twice a week instead of monthly to try and get the program back on track. It comes as the TGA investigates a second case of blood clotting linked to the AstraZeneca jab. Meantime, US health officials have put the rollout of the Johnson & Johnson COVID vaccine on pause over blood clot fears. Nearly 7 million people have received the one-shot vaccine across the United States, and there have been 6 cases of a rare blood clotting disorder, including one death. Coronavirus restrictions will ease from tomorrow morning in Queensland. It comes as the Nurses Union voices its concerns that masks aren't being fitted properly on workers in COVID wards. Here's Adam Hegarty with the details.
Well, the context here is Brisbane's 3-day lockdown was sparked when the virus escaped COVID wards. Doctors and nurses catching COVID-19 in those wards while wearing the proper PPE and then taking it out into the community. On that note, the AMA conducted a survey of 365 frontline health staff and found a staggering 70% weren't being properly fitted with masks or fit tested with those more sophisticated masks. Now, the Nurses Union is getting involved, taking Queensland Health to the Industrial Relations Commission this afternoon, claiming health management still aren't giving assurances that masks are being fitted onto frontline workers. We put this to the Premier and she was taken aback.
I'd rather let the health experts talk about that, if that's okay. I'll let the health experts talk about that. And there has been some, my understanding is some upgrading of the wearing of PPE that Dr. Young put in place.
The good news today, though, is there will be an easing of COVID-19 restrictions in Queensland from 6 a.m. tomorrow. Masks will no longer be required indoors. Visitors will be allowed back into hospitals and aged care homes, and there will also be dancing and standing allowed again at licensed venues. That is, of course, because we've now had 14 days of no community transmission.
And residents in Melbourne's east are being urged to get tested if they have any coronavirus symptoms after fragments were detected in wastewater. No new cases have been recorded in Victoria today. However, those who live in the Ringwood area, including Bayswater, Croydon and Wanturna, are on alert. Anyone who visited the area from April 6 to 9 should also get tested if they have any symptoms. A pilot and his teenage passenger have died when their light plane crashed in Sutton outside of Canberra. The pair, aged 31 and 18, were undertaking aerial inspections of electricity works for Essential Energy when their aircraft ran into trouble.
I've been to a number of plane crashes over my years of service and they're all horrific scenes.
Today, authorities are combing the paddock to try and figure out what caused the crash. The search for missing Victorian campers Russell Hill and Carol Clay has this morning moved to Mount Hotham. Elizabeth Moss has the details.
Less than a dozen search and rescue officers have descended on Mount Hotham this morning as part of their investigation into the missing pair. They're making their way down the steep mountainside, combing through this rugged terrain. Exactly what they're searching for isn't clear, but police say they're acting on information that's been uncovered as part of their missing persons investigation. The pair haven't been seen or heard from since last March. Russell Hill and Carol Clay were camping in the Wanangatta Valley in Victoria's High Country. Mr Hill's Land Cruiser was later found with minor fire damage. Their campsite was destroyed by fire. More than 12 months since the pair's disappearance, it's clear detectives aren't giving up on finding out exactly what happened to Russell Hill and Carol Clay.